your man by the company.
We've been friends for a long time.
Gio. Are you planning on spending any time in Armadillo, Mr. Marston?
I doubt it. I ain't planning on staying very long.
Well, if you're fixing for some female company, you can do a lot worse than Armadillo. Fine as cream gravy they are. Not like Thieves Landing. Dang, those girls ain't even fit for a drinking man to hole up with.
I'm a married man, I'm afraid.
Ain't we all? It was the marshal who hired me. Lee Johnson, do you know him?
I think I heard his name.
Says he got a telegram from some Blackwater big bugs asking for a guide. I guess it's none of my business.
That's right.
Yeah, yeah. But you ain't very talkative, are you?
Nope.
I'm just chewing the dog, mister. It's how I am. I don't mean nothing by it.
Trust me, there's things you're better off not knowing.
I'll tell you, Mr. Marston, those coyotes eat better than I do. Not far now. You'll see the fort when you get to the top of this hill.
Easy.
Uno. Listen, mister. This here is what's left of Fort Mercer. Some gang rode in and took the place over.
So I understand.
This is where we part ways, friend. You have yourself a good time.
Well, you're alive.
So it would seem.
So, how do you feel?
I don't know the polite word for it.
I do. Stupid is the word we use around here. What were you doing?
I was doing something stupid.
Well, you'll be okay. Once you didn't die, the doctor said you'd be fine. He got the bullets out a couple days ago.
Good.
It cost us $15.
I'm sorry, madam. Should have left me there to die.
Did you want to die? I mean, was that it? Was that why you went straight out to Fort Mercer and picked a fight with the worst bandit in the county? To die, Mr.
Mr. Marston. John Marston. Figured it's about time I started paying back that $15.
Well, no time to waste. The horses are saddled up over here. Office. It's also where we lock up good-for-nothing outlaws, such as yourself.
I'm happy enough with my current quarters right now, Miss McFarland.
Okay, let's see if you can still ride a horse.
I'll show you around the property.
Let's go.
To your right is the general store. You won't find Parisian high fashion, but it's good for the essentials.
Very convenient. I don't think I've ever seen a ranch with its own store before.
And here's the corral. This one's for the horses. What do you think?
I'm no expert, but it certainly looks like a fine corral.
I suspect you've stolen more horses than you've broken.
Now, where'd you get such an idea?
First impressions are hard to erase. That's the train station. Things sure have changed since the line finally got finished, bringing in all sorts of new folk like yourself.
Is that such a bad thing?
Change is only good when it makes things better. That's the barn over there. Paul built it himself when I was just a little girl.
Slow it up now. Come on!
And here we are, back at the house. Let's stop for a while before we head out on patrol.
You'll get no complaints from me, Miss McFarland.
Well, are we going inside? How about a cold drink, Mr. Marston?
Thank you, ma'am. Getting shot, then riding a horse seems to take it out of you. I could use a rest.
Sure. Come on in. I'll show you the house, and then you can sit for a while.
Thank you.
Mr. Marston.
Miss McFarland.
Remember me telling you about the trouble we've been having with rustlers and other undesirables?
I do.
Will you help me keep watch on the property line this evening?
Sure.
I want to see just who is trespassing on our land.
This is a fine weapon.
Come, let's head out. The country is really beautiful at around this time. Come on, then. Let's mount up and take a look around.
Let's go!
Right, follow me. Keep your eyes peeled for anything suspicious. Thank you, Mr. Marston. I feel a lot happier someone's along with me.
I feel a lot happier now I got a rifle.
Well, with your trigger itch and my feminine intuition, we should make quite a team. Rabbits are at it again. Come on, let's get rid of them once and for all.
Maybe you should move to a big city, become a lady of leisure. Come on!
Look out! Coyotes! Shoot them before they get to the air!
way to your room. You know, you can actually handle a rifle.
It's something I've had a little experience in.
Maybe Bill Williamson did get lucky after all.
Luck didn't really come into it, miss.
You're a useful man to have around the ranch, that's for sure. But don't think I've forgotten what brought you here. We'll do whatever we can to help you.
I sure appreciate that, Miss McFarland.
This is you, Mr. Marston. Thank you for your help, Mr. Marston. Makes me kind of happy I saved your life. Get some sleep and I will see you in the morning.
Good night, Miss McFarland.
Let's go!
Come on, easy up now!
Mr. Marston, how are you doing today?
I'm well, Miss McFarland. Thank you. How are you?
Well, I'm fine. Thank you. So, how are your ribs?
Fine. A little sore, but apart from a couple extra scars, it'll be as nothing happened.
Good. Come in. You know, you never did tell me how you met that Bill Williamson or what you wanted from him.
No, miss, I did not.
Well, why not, if you don't mind me asking?
I certainly don't mind you asking if you don't mind me not telling. See, it's a complicated and somewhat pathetic tale, and by telling you, not only would I be putting your life in danger, but also threatening the lives of some people that I hold very dear.
Well, I apologize if I seem to be prying.
And I apologize for my reticence. Hope you believe me when I say that it's simply out of respect for you.
Of course, Mr. Marston. I understand that a city dweller such as yourself likes to have some exotic secrets, so us country folk are impressed.
I'm no city man, miss.
Yeah, but I saw you get on the train at Blackwater. You with those gentlemen in bowler hats?
I'm still no city man.
But I'll bet you can't ride, Mr. Marston.
I hate to take money from a lady, miss.
Oh, you won't be. I'll race you right now.
If it makes you happy.
We'll see. I'll show you how we ride around these parts.
on the count of three. 3, 2, 1, go! I trust you're not gonna be a gentleman about this!
You don't know me at all, Miss McFarland. What are you doing back there? Yeah, I bet you're starting to regret your brave words, Miss McFarland. Come, would you like me to slow down? Should I wait for you to catch up? Go. Are you saving the best for last?
On the count of three. 3.
Whoa!
Yeah.
Sure.
You know, you should go pay the marshal a visit in Armadillo sometime. I'm sure he could help you deal with that nice Mr. Williamson.
Yeah, I might just do that, Miss McFarland.
You do whatever you think's best, Mr. Marston. How are you?
Good, Miss McFarland. How are you?
I'm well. Would you mind riding with me to Armadillo? I've got to get some supplies and I could do with the company.
Of course.
You can take the reins. It wouldn't do for a terrifying bounty hunter such as yourself to be seen driven around by a woman. Take the reins, Mr. Marston. You're looking much better, considering you were almost buzzard food a couple days ago.
I have you to thank for that, miss.
So do tell me, have you needlessly risked your life since we last spoke?
Will you stop playing with your gun and watch the road? Hop on up, Mr. Marston. Perhaps, but not rotten. I just worry about you gallivanting around these parts like you're some kind of deranged bounty hunter. Like Paul always says, don't go waking snakes.
I appreciate your concern for us lesser mortals, Miss McFarland. I really do. And if there was any other way out, I'd take it. I can assure you of that.
A farmer? Yeah, and I'm the Queen of England. And at what point during your day of hunting down outlaws do you find time to raise chickens?
Only been at it 3 years or so. I guess I'm kind of new to it.
You're telling me? So who's looking after this farm of yours right now?
Uncle. Well, he's not my uncle, as far as I know. Just an old dog who's as lazy as a lizard on a hot day. Kind of fella laboring under the delusion that age brings wisdom.
The perfect person to leave in charge of your entire livelihood.
We go way back, and I didn't have a lot of choice.
I'd be getting back there if I was you.
That's what I'm trying to do, miss.
How well do you know New Austin?
I don't. We talked about coming down here many times, but never made it.
Who's we?
Me and the folks I used to work with. Yeah, New Austin. The last real outlaw country, where the old ways still hold true. Do a man wrong, he'll shoot you for it. Do a man right, well, he still may shoot you for it. But at least you have an idea of what's right and what's wrong there.
Dear, oh dear, Mr. Marston, what dreadful novel did you get that romanticized drivel out of? Those days are long gone, if they were ever here at all. So this is Armadillo. Manhattan it is not, but it does okay for us. Most important thing for you right now is getting yourself into Dr. Johnson's office to purchase some medicine. The first one's on me.
Thank you, miss. I'll pay you back.
I'm sure you shall. The doc's a good fellow. He saved your life, so be polite to him. Meet me in front of the general.
Hello there. whole town needs my extra guys today.
Hey, partner.
Finally come to get that bullet out your leg.
Maybe it's time I bought a new buggy. Or perhaps a racker. Parks.
Enjoy the day, mister.
How do you do, sir?
Better get fitted with the new suit to see in town. We got all these new...
Well, hello there.
Turn the other cheek.
Well, thanks for driving me. It was nice to be able to enjoy the view for once, and a little company never hurts now and again.
You're more than welcome, miss. Least I can do. Thank you for the medicine.
Why don't you have a look around Armadillo? You can always take the stagecoach back to the ranch later.
I might just do that. Travel safely, miss.
Try not to get yourself shot. I won't be around to save you this time.
How are you, friend?
Hey, how good it is to see you.
Good morning, friend. Morning to you, partner.
Hello there.
I'm so sorry, sir.
Excuse me, sir.
Have a good day, partner.
Back home, the bacon was sweeter than it is out here.
Oh, this weather makes me happy.
Ain't it always the
way? Raced in front of the Lord.
Careful.
Thank you, partner.
Hey, you! Get to that guy! Come over here!
You done diddling yourself? Put them fingers on the table and show me your skill.
Good morning to you, dear sir.